Hi friends, welcome to the Angular Interview Concepts with Explanation series. In this series, I'm explaining some of the concepts those are most focused on Angular interviews. If you just prepare for your Angular interview, like a question and answer format, it won't help you a lot. If the same question is asked differently, you may struggle. Instead, if you understand the core concept behind that, you will not forget forever and you can easily answer. That is what I'm trying to explain with some examples. Let's start. There are two ways we can provide a dependency in Angular. Either we can use the providedIn property in the @injectable decorator or using the providers array. But what is the difference between these two ways? Usually, I used to ask this question while I take interviews. I will not reject if they don't know the answer of this question. But I will give preference to people who answer this correctly. Let me explain this using a simple example. I have created an Angular app and in this, I have a home component and an user module. In my router module, I have few routes and I have configured to open the home component when the application loads. And I have not created any router links and so I can directly go to the user page through the URL. In the user module, I have the user component in which I'm just showing a list of users. These users are present in this shared service. And so I wanted to convey that I am using this shared service only in this component. I have created this shared service through CLI and you can notice the CLI has added this. Before Angular 6, the CLI will not create this @injectable section and also we will add the @injectable decorator only if we are going to inject this service into another service. Okay, what does this providedIn mean? Do we need this @injectable decorator? Actually, we don't need this part. Let me comment this. But we can see we are getting this error. I have already explained about this in couple of my previous videos in which I have explained about dependency injection and why we need to provide a dependency. That is an interesting video. If you like to see, you can get the link from the description of this video. Okay, let me explain why we are getting this error. This provided in root means we are providing this service in the root module. And as we have commented this, now we are not providing this anywhere. Let me go to my root module and provide this service there using the providers array. Now we can see our application is working again. That means we can understand we can either provide a service using the providedIn root inside the @injectable decorator or we can provide it in the providers array of the root component. Now my question is what is the difference between these two ways? We cannot see any visual difference between the way they both work. Then why we have two options? Okay, let me talk about the differences now. First of all, the providedIn property provides a more concise and convenient way to register a service. In the service file itself, we can specify in which module the service has to be provided. In the meantime, using the providers array provides us more control. We can provide it at different levels, such as at the root level, within a feature module, or even at a component level. In case we need to create a separate instance of a dependency in two different modules, we can achieve that easily using the providers array. The next important point is services provided using providedIn are tree shakeable. That means if a service is not used anywhere in the application, the service and its associated code will be removed during the build process to reduce bundle size. In the meantime, services provided in the providers array are eagerly loaded by default when the module is imported, which means they are created as soon as the application starts. Services provided in the providers array are typically not tree shakeable. Even if a service is not used, it will still be included in the bundle. In summary, the choice between providedIn and the providers array depends on your specific use case and preferences. ProvidedIn is generally preferred for global services that are used throughout the application, while the providers array is more appropriate when you need explicit control over where and how the service is provided. Keep in mind that services provided in the providers array are not reshakable by default. So it's important to manage your dependencies carefully to avoid unnecessary bloat in your application bundles. Hope you understood the differences now. Please subscribe to my channel and support me. I'll be back with another concept soon. Thank you. Bye.